Hello everyone, today we will be covering the groups tree palette in Formit. I've placed a handful of groups and nested groups in the canvas to demonstrate. Let's begin by selecting the groups tree icon from the palette toolbar. This palette will report all groups currently in the model, and the status column shows which groups are currently being edited and if it is from Dynamo or Revit. From here, if we select a group, it will highlight in the canvas. If it is nested, it will appear within the parent group dropdown. So you can see how the pyramid is a standalone group, but also exists within the cube group. Regardless of groups being nested, their name will remain the same, so if I expand all of my nested groups and change the pyramid name by right-clicking it and select Rename Group and change it to the Great Pyramid, you will see it updates every instance of that group in the tree. If I edit a group in the canvas and then the nested group, you can see how the group's tree updates to show me which group I am currently modifying. I can also edit the groups from the group tree by right-clicking on a group and selecting Edit the Group, which will automatically put you in Group Edit. To assist with this action, you can go to the Settings menu in the standard toolbar and turn on Hide Group Context or use the keyboard shortcut H, which will hide everything outside of the group I am editing, and then press the Zoom Selection icon, or ZS, to center the group in your view. You can right-click on a group and delete it, or press the Delete Group button. It's important to note that this completely deletes the group. If you simply want to ungroup it, go to the canvas, select the group, and right-click to the context menu to select Ungroup, or press the keyboard shortcut U. You can change a group's category so that Insight can use the correct category for energy analysis. Inactive groups are referring to groups that have been deleted. If I go to the Content Library palette and place a sofa, it will appear in the main sketch of the groups tree. If I delete it, it moves to the inactive groups. And that's it for Formit Groups Tree Palette. Be sure to check out more videos on the Formit YouTube channel.